Ladies and gentlemen, say hello to the fans who are watching at home on the live stream. We'll be starting in just a couple minutes. In just a few. Thank you. introducing today's master of ceremonies, the voice of the Danbury Westerners, Christian Gardecki.
Check.
Hey. Sorry, I got a pebble in my shoe. Hang on. Shocker. All right. Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Let me just get the script out real quick. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Rogers Park. Today is a super special day. Many of you have been waiting for this day for 26 years. Many of you for half of your lives. It's been a long time coming for the Danbury Westerners. And I am so happy to be a part of it. Once again, I am the voice of the Danbury Westerners on the broadcast. You heard me scream last night. They're a team of destiny. Because these guys really are. This season, the Westerners, I mean, it was special. 10 come-from-behind victories. 2 walk-off grand slams over Newport. We finished the season 7-0 against Newport, our biggest rival. Today is a celebration. We are celebrating the first ever Danbury Westerners Faye Vincent Senior Cup Championship. The Westerners have never won the championship in this league, as I just said. Well, they've been around the longest in one spot continuously. Today's event is brought to you by the people doing some ring sizing, Morton's Jewelry in Bethel, Connecticut. Let's bring out our good friend, by the way, Homer. Westy's little brother, cousin, I don't know. Your Danbury Westerners won 23 games in the regular season, as I said before, including all 7 against the Newport Gulls. Our playoff run started with a wild card game right here against Newport. And we won 6-1, going to 8-0 on the Gulls this season. Then we went to Holyoke, swept the Blue Sox in 2, won game 1 in Holyoke, game 2 right here at Rogers Park. Who was here? Yeah. In the division finals, we took on the number 1 seed and defending NECBL Southern Division champion Martha's Vineyard Sharks. They were defending NECBL Southern Division champions. Game 1, we won on the island. Game 2, don't really want to talk about it. Game 3, though. The Westerners were up 3-1 in the 5th. Martha's Vineyard scored 5 runs. Then, after that, in the 8th inning, we had the bases loaded, a double play, 5-4. The Westerners hit a pop-up that is dropped by the Martha's Vineyard first baseman, and we tie the game. Then, the Westerners took the lead in the 9th, and we're on to their first NECBL Championship Series in 9 years. Then, the other night here at Rogers Park was special. Took on the North Shore Navigators in a very, very fun game. Westerners won 13-5, powered by many, many home runs. Last night, Westerners got down 3-0 early, and then came back. Matt Zaffino with a 3-run bomb made it 5-3 Westerners, and they never looked back. In the 9th inning, Coleman Picard comes in the game and shuts down the door, and I said the words that we've been waiting 26 years to hear. The Westerners are NECBL champions! Last night, we had a bunch of fans with us. Here's our good friend Westy. We had a bunch of fans with us last night. Over 25 Westerner fans came out. And on June 26th, our second baseman from Georgia Tech, John Anderson, said these following words: "The Danbury Westerners are the grittiest team in the NECBL, and that is true. Is it?" This championship, last night, I was talking with Paul Schaefer, President Emeritus, and he has dedicated this championship to the memory of 4 men who were instrumental with the Westerners throughout the years. Bill Poland of the Jimmy Fund, Mike Malone, Terry Whalen, and NECBL co-founder Joseph Constantino. Before we meet the players, we'd like to thank our awesome staff. First, our interns taking time out of their summer to do an awesome job with us. If you are here, please raise your hand. Our scoreboard operator, Grace Rudick. Stream producer in charge of our Synergy Canada's and cameras, John Farrell, not here. Official scorer, Alex DeVorsets. Audio operator, Daniel Madison. Camera operator, Jasper Nussbaum. Public address announcer, Andrew Van Cura. Game day operations, Tim McGrath, Andrew Forster, and Jenna Karpowicz, who also doubled as PA announcer. Social media and graphics, David Willen. Analytics guy, Connor Meisner. And team journalist, Kyle DeSantis, who is upstairs in the press box. Next up, our awesome volunteers, if I forget your name, I apologize, but from taking tickets to selling 50-50 raffles to cheering on the team loudly, please raise your hands, Melissa, Olivia, Danielle, Manny, Lucian, Victor, Dima, Jenna, and Connor. Thank you guys. You guys are what makes us run. The people who feed us. Our team mom, Miss Sherry Tyrell. She is the best team mom you could ask for. These are her boys of summer, right here in Danbury. Missy Nathanson and our host family coordinator, Shelly Pitzer, who is here with us. Speaking of the host families, our host families are what keep us rolling. They feed our players and give them a place to live for 2.5 months each summer. Let's give them a round of applause for our host families. If you are here, please stand. Got one. And of course, our sponsors. Without them, we would not be here. You may see their signage around the ballpark. We thank them. Now, our board members. If you are here, please raise your hand or stand up. Bob Brott. John Constantino. Lee Day. Also, I want to thank one more person. Totally forgot about this. Our team athletic trainers, Aaron Kapopoulos and Amy Schneider. Amy's here tonight. Give a round of applause. They do such a great job with our team. Also does Lee Day with Hasidy Physical Therapy. Dr. Fred Gadberry. Fred, there you are. Alex Giobi, our director of player personnel. Marty Greenfield. Dr. Matt Hartsburg of Hartsburg Chiropractic. Kevin McNellis, Jen Morandi, Mike Nathanson, Kevin Patrick, Nick Wolf, Trisha Coe, and our executive committee, Vice President and General Manager Chris Nathanson, who is not with us today, Secretary Mark Kovac, Treasurer, Host Family Coordinator Shelly Pitzer, Vice President of Community and Public Relations Bill Guider, Vice President of Marketing and Operations, taking the pictures, Mark Morash. Counselor, Bill Slifkin. President Emeritus, Paul Schaefer. And last but not least, the President of the Danbury Westerners, Mr. John Pitzer. Now, first, there are a bunch of players that are not here yet here, so we'll just honor them because they were part of our team for a long time this season. First pitcher, University of Houston, Josh Brown. Pitcher, Long Beach State, I don't think he's here, Ethan Clough. Number 13, Sean Hogan. Is Hogan here? No, Hogan is not. Sean Hogan. Number 4, Bucknell, Ren Lintz. Number 8, Jake Marshall from Lemoyne College. Number 26, Vincent McDermott. Number 43, Coleman Picard. Number 22, Kyle Roach. Number 28, Jack Payton. Number 0, Logan Vandenbecker. Number 31, Luke Schlinger. Number 32, John Anderson. Number 3, Banks Griffith. Number 29, Andrew Jenkins. Number 16, Justin Kapuscinski. Number 33, Hank Thomas. Number 18, Tristan Sarconi. Number 39, Cameron Nordgren. And number five, Zach Selinger. All right, now let's meet the guys that are here. Let's start with number 40 from St. Peter's University, Christian Coombs. Number 37 from right here in Danbury, from Trinity College, Jimmy Fahey. Next up, number 41 from Northwestern University, Michael Farinelli. Number 21 from Elon University, Noah Jensen. Number 27 from Niagara University, Blake McMillan. Oh, McDermott's here, my bad. Number 26, now he just got here, Vincent McDermott from St. Thomas Aquinas. Next up, number 35, also from Danbury, from Manhattan College, Justin Solomon. Another pitcher from Georgetown University, number 45, Angelo Tonis. Next up, let's go to the infielders. Number 25 from Richmond, Will Gerske. Next up, from Maryland, College Park, number 11, Nick LaRusso. Next up, another infielder, number 6 from Long Beach State, Sebastian Murillo. Next up for the Westerners, the outfielders from Sacred Heart University, number 1, Justin Jordan. Not here, I forgot to mention this. Not here, number 24, Cameron Masterman. Next up, from Palm Beach Atlantic, from Bethel, Connecticut as well, number 7, Jay Grouper. Also up next, from the University of Dayton, number 14, Henry Stramecki. The last position player, number 2, Matt Zaffino from Fairfield University. Now the coaching staff for the Westerners. Actually, first we'll start with the director of player personnel once again, Alex Giobi. Let's get up for Alex. He is the one who helped build this team. Next up, let's bring out assistant coach number 23, Connor Farrell. Nice shorts, Connor. Next up, hitting coach number 9, Bobby Rodriguez. We also invite any board member who'd like to sit up here in the front row, please come out. You guys are a huge part of our team. You guys have done so much. Once again, Bobby Rodriguez, though. The pitching coach for the Danbury Westerners. He's also the head coach at Immaculate High School, Mr. Dean White. And the manager, right here from Danbury, UConn Avery Point, former Western himself, number 10, Ian Ratchford. We have one more player to announce, who just got here. From Manhattan College, catcher number 0, Logan Vandenbecker. And the moment you've been waiting for, coming out with a Faye Vincent Senior Cup. He is our majestic stallion. He is number 19, Christian Allegretti, and the Faye Vincent Senior Cup. Christian, put it right here. Thank you very much, Christian. Now, we're going to have a few words first from the manager of the Danbury Westerners, Ian Ratchford.
First off, just want to thank everybody for coming out today. I want to thank you guys. Without you, this wouldn't be possible. Sticking around all summer is a tough task. And staying here all summer and doing what you guys did was unbelievable. So, thank you guys. Mr. Pitzer, Mr. Schaefer, everybody, all the board members, all the volunteers. I understand how much time and effort you guys put into this to make this possible and give these guys this opportunity, so thank you. And the fans, the city of Danbury, thank you. Happy to have this thing home.
Thank you, Ian. Alex Giobi? Director of Player Personnel, him and Chris Nathanson helped build this team. They wanted to bring this team, and they brought a championship team this year, so this man deserves a lot of credit for getting these guys here. Alex Giobi.
First of all, I want to thank everybody who came out here today. I want to thank John Pitzer. I want to thank Shelley Pitzer. I want to thank everybody on the board. I want to thank Chris for taking a chance on me as Director of Player Personnel. I want to thank everyone here, everyone who isn't here. We couldn't have done what we had done without the cohesion, without the unity, without the performance that we did. And I can honestly say, I am so proud of everyone who has taken the part of this team. I can honestly say, everyone who took part of this team, take a long look in the mirror. Because you know why? You are champions. And nobody can take that away from you.
Thank you, Alex. I received a message this morning, one guy who couldn't be here, he was headed back to school. Is Cam Masterman. He's been here for 2 years now. One of our all-stars this year. There goes my papers. Great. He wanted me to read off a message he sent for this team, for me to read. To everyone in Danbury, the volunteers, interns, board members, host families, I wish I was here, but I'm headed back to school. But I thank you all so much for making my 2 summers here in Danbury the most memorable of my life. You guys mean the world to me. I'm glad we brought the trophy right to where it belongs here in Danbury. Roll Westies. Next up, he's the team leader, basically. Number 19, Christian Allegretti.
Hey guys, how is everyone doing today? I know you're feeling good, we just won a championship. So on our jerseys, it says Westerners, but on the whites and the black jerseys, it says Danbury on top. And for 26 years, Danbury Westerners, unfortunately haven't been able to secure that cup. But this year, this team, we're going to go down in history, and we finally did it. We brought the championship back to Danbury for the people. We are the people's champion for Danbury. So thank you. And I just want to say thank you from the bottom of my heart and from the bottom of our hearts. I'm speaking for the team here. From the smile zone all the way to the beer garden to the people out in the outfield, thank you so much. Everything you guys do for us, the cheering on the team, hoping that we win, it goes a long way, and we can't thank you enough. And to the volunteers, the board members, the investors for our squad, we just can't thank you enough. And I'm just so proud to say we brought this Vincent Fay Cup here, and let's go. Danbury Weston is baby. Salud.
I'd like to welcome out one more Western out to the field. Coleman Picard, when you're ready, come on out. Give a round of applause for Coleman, because he's did a great job for us this season. All right. I just want to say personally, I've been with this team as a fan, as a bat boy since 2012. The emotions we had last night are something I will never, never, ever forget. These guys are truly special. This is going to be something I'll never forget. But now, it's time for you guys to celebrate. We'll be out on the concourse or around the grandstands signing autographs. You can take pictures with the Faye Vincent Senior Cup as well. But before we go, from the bottom of everybody's heart, thank you so much for supporting us throughout the years. It means the world, as Christian meant to this team. These guys have worked so hard for you guys throughout the years. We cannot wait to see you in 2022. Let's hit that music. Let's go, Westerners. Let's give it up for your 2021 NECVL Faye Vincent Senior Cup champions, Danbury Westerners. All right, we're going to come in for a quick picture around the trophy. Play, come on, Eileen. Thanks. All right, let's come around this trophy. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2021 Faye Vincent Senior Cup champion, Danbury Westerners! Hit that music. Fans, you may be able to come out and take pictures with the trophy and get autographs from your favorite Westerners.